Picture this, you need something, a small plastic part, a custom organizer, a replacement piece that doesn't exist in stores. In the old world, you drive around town, order online and wait days, or just live with the problem. But 20 minutes after I had this exact problem, I was holding the solution in my hands. Not because I bought it, not because I'm some engineering genius, because I manufactured it. If you've been waiting for the right time to get into 3D printing, that time is now, and I'm going to show you exactly why. I've been circling 3D printing for years, you probably have too. There were projects in the back of my mind, like little fixes I wanted to try, creative ideas I couldn't make happen, but every time I got close to pulling the trigger, the same doubts crept in. Would I spend more time fixing the printer than actually printing? Am I really going to learn 3D modeling just to make a phone stand? Those doubts kept me on the sidelines until I realized I was asking the wrong questions. The real question wasn't whether 3D printing was worth it. The question was, which printer? I'd narrowed it down to two options, the Bambu Lab A1 Mini that everyone recommends for beginners, or the bigger P1S. Both are excellent, but here's why the P1S won. Space. Surprisingly, everyone says the Mini is more compact, but that's only true if you don't get the AMS, the multi-material system. With the AMS, the Mini sprawls across your desk like an awkward teenager. The P1S stacks everything vertically, cleaner, more compact where it actually matters. The enclosure changed everything, not just because it looks professional, but because it unlocks stronger materials like PETG and ABS. The Mini limits you to PLA, which is fine for most things, but what if you want to print something that needs to hold real weight or last outdoors under the UV of the sun or higher temperatures? And the build volume. That extra space isn't just about printing bigger things, though I definitely had dreams of a mini arcade cabinet. It's about printing more things at once. Time is the real limitation, not plastic. But here's the detail that sealed it. Filament management. The P1S handles the waste from color changes, what the community calls poop, so much cleaner than the Mini. When you're doing multicolor prints, this matters more than you think. The decision made, I started hunting for deals, and that's when I found it. A Facebook marketplace listing that seemed too good to be true. Someone had bought a P1S just 2 weeks earlier, set it up, even installed some modifications, but then a friend offered him an X1C, and suddenly he had two printers and needed to sell one. Practically brand new, already dialed in, modifications included, and price to move fast. I pulled the trigger before my brain could talk me out of it, which is how all my best decisions happen. When I got it home, I expected at least some setup hassle. Even used, these things must need some calibration, right? Wrong. I reattached the AMS, plugged it in, ran the automatic calibration, and within 30 minutes, I was watching my first print emerge, the classic benchy boat. No troubleshooting, no failed attempts, no cursing at confusing software. The previous owner had already done all the hard work, and frankly, there wasn't much to begin with. It just worked. I'd set it up between two shelving units perched on top of a couple of my JVC monitors, because nothing says I've thought this through like stacking a brand new printer on expensive retro gaming equipment. But hey, they were the right height and surprisingly sturdy, so it worked. The AMS sat on top like it belonged there. And when that little orange boat finished printing, using the sample filament that comes with the P1S, sharp details, smooth surfaces, no obvious flaws, I stared at it like I'd just witnessed magic. During setup, the bamboo slicer asks you to name your printer. I noticed the previous owner had already installed some blue mods and the name just came to me. Printimus Prime. It just fit. This was either going to be the best purchase I'd ever made, or I was about to become insufferably annoying to everyone I know. Spoiler, it was both. But I still didn't understand. Not yet. A week later, I was trying to fix a sticky door lock. I grabbed my WD-40 can from the shed and discovered what every homeowner dreads. The little red straw was missing. You know, that tiny piece of plastic that's somehow critical to the entire operation? Gone. Probably living its best life behind the lawnmower. Old me would have driven to the hardware store, bought a new can, maybe grabbed some lunch while I was out, made it a whole afternoon project. Instead, I sat down at my PC, searched WD-40 straw on MakerWorld, found exactly what I needed, designed by someone who'd clearly had the exact same problem. Downloaded the file, sent it to the printer. 20 minutes later, I was holding a perfect replacement. That's when it hit me. This wasn't just a cool gadget. I installed a manufacturing capability in my home. Any object someone had ever thought to design, and they'd thought of everything. everything I could have in minutes, not days, for pennies, not dollars. I wasn't just printing plastic trinkets, I was bending reality to solve problems. And here's what makes this moment in time different from even 3 years ago. All the barriers finally fell at once. Bambu Lab basically did for 3D printing what Apple did for smartphones. They made complex technology feel simple and reliable enough for regular people. The community exploded, millions of designs, all free, all tested, and the technology matured to the point where you don't need any technical skills whatsoever. This is the first time in 3D printing history where someone like me, not an engineer, not a hobbyist tinkerer, can just use one, like a regular appliance. Once you realize you can manufacture solutions, you start seeing problems everywhere. But more than that, you start seeing problems differently. Before the printer, a missing part was just an annoyance you lived with, a small inconvenience that was just part of life. Now, every friction point becomes an opportunity. Every "I wish I had" becomes "I can make that." It's a complete psychological shift in how you move through the world. You develop manufacturing eyes. It's like getting superpowers, except instead of fighting crime, you're just really annoying at parties. See that hook? I could print a better one. This organizer sucks. Give me 3 hours. My family loves it. My daughter's basketball shoes were a pain for her to put on. Twice a week, before training and games, it was like watching someone try to put socks on a cat. A couple of hours later, custom shoehorns that make it way easier for her to slide her feet into them on her own. My HomePod Mini needed a wall mount, but Apple doesn't make one. A few hours later, problem solved. I needed a better way to open packages. An hour and a half later, a retractable knife that looks better and is way more convenient than the box cutter I'd been using. And here's the thing, I can start any of these prints remotely on my phone using the handy app. See a problem during the day, queue up a solution, and come home to find it waiting. The manufacturing capability isn't just in your home, it's in your pocket. But the real magic happened when my daughter got involved. We made a multicolor Mother's Day gift using the AMS, even though neither of us had any real experience. We printed a suspended heart for her grandmother, a red heart that appears to float amongst the white strings in a 3D cylinder, creating this beautiful illusion. A decorative succulent plant for her teacher that looks as good as the real thing, but with none of the maintenance or fear of letting it die. We printed football bookmarks for her friends, and then I discovered something really cool, cat-themed bookmark that I could make as little surprise rewards for her reading more. One of them had a design where I could swap out the white filament in the slicer to give the cats different colored eyes. So I printed three versions, same bookmark, but one with white eyes, one with yellow, and one with green. I didn't tell her I was making them, I just said there would be a surprise when she completed her reading tasks. I'd then leave one on her desk for her to find, then another, watching her excitement grow each time she discovered a new one was worth every minute of print time. And then we discovered fidgets. One of the first ones my daughter got me to print was this little orange cat fidget, simple, cute, and satisfying to play with. Then came the marble castle desk toy with real magnets and bearing, the spiral pass-through fidget, the 12-in-1 fidget in translucent PETG that catches light like a prism. This is where I realized something crucial. 3D printing isn't just about printing plastic parts anymore. You're building hybrid objects, combining printed components with real hardware. Screws, magnets, bearings, elastic bands. The MakerWorld beginner kit opened my eyes to this completely. And honestly, this was just the beginning. I hadn't even started printing things for my gaming setup yet. Headphone holders, controller stands, display pieces, but I'm getting ahead of myself. That's a whole nother rabbit hole. Here's what I thought 3D printing was. Constant tinkering, failed prints, and projects that took forever and might not even work. Here's what it actually is. As simple as sending something to a paper printer. You find what you want, click print, and come back later to find it finished. The reliability is shocking. In months of printing, I've had maybe 3 failures, and 2 of those were my fault. Yes, big prints still take hours, but compared to the old days when a single print could take over a day and fail halfway through, it's a revolution. The Bambu printers changed everything. They made 3D printing boring in the best possible way. No drama, no babysitting, no expertise required. You just print things. The P1S has become both a tool and a hobby for me. Some weeks I'm printing practical solutions, organizers, mounts, fixes around the house. Other weeks it's pure creativity. Gifts, fidgets, experiments with my daughter. Because it's enclosed and can handle tougher materials, I'm not just limited to decorative objects. I can print functional parts that hold real weight, withstand heat, or replace broken components. The big dream project, a mini arcade cabinet modeled after the classic Sega candy cabs, complete with a 9.7 inch screen and single player controls. Multiple prints, electronics, finishing work, a project that would have been impossible for someone like me just a few years ago. The achievable goal? Lithophanes, printing photographs into translucent plastic that come to life with backlighting. With the AMS and CMYK filaments, I can even try color lithophanes using MakerWorld's lithophane tool. And then there's Makers UForge, a tool for creating multicolored wall art that I haven't even tried yet, but I'm looking forward to. The possibilities just keep expanding. But here's what I didn't expect. Once you have a printer, you start noticing solutions. Problems you lived with for years suddenly become 20-minute fixes. Ideas you've had but couldn't execute become weekend projects. You develop manufacturing eyes. If you're watching this and you've been hesitating like I was, here's what actually matters. You don't need to learn 3D modeling. 99% of what you'll ever want to print already exists. People have had your exact problem and solved it already. You don't need to be technical. The MakerWorld app makes it literally point and click. Find what you want, send it to the printer, and hit go. The material cost is almost nothing. Filament is shockingly affordable, as low as $10 for a kilogram, which is enough for dozens of useful prints. Most small objects use just a few grams. That WD-40 straw, probably 2 or 3 cents worth of plastic. Even larger prints rarely cost more than $1 or $2 in material. The variety keeps it interesting. Matte finishes, translucent colors, flexible materials, super strong engineering plastics, each one opens up new possibilities. I've been sticking with Bambu Lab filament as a beginner to learn what different materials can do, and they run sales often enough that stocking up isn't expensive. Plus, their spools come with RFID tags that tell the AMS exactly what filament it is. No manual selection, no guessing. You just load it and the printer knows. Super convenient. What you need is not expertise. What you need is curiosity about what becomes possible when you can manufacture anything. 6 months in, I can tell you exactly what buying a 3D printer actually gets you. It's not just a machine, it's a superpower. The ability to think, I need this, and have it in your hands the same day. The ability to look at any problem and know there's probably a solution waiting to be printed. Most importantly, it's the ability to stop being a consumer and start being a creator. That 20-minute WD-40 straw wasn't just fixing a door lock. It was proof that the future of manufacturing isn't in factories across the ocean. It's sitting on your desk. Or in my case, on some expensive retro monitors, waiting for the next problem to solve. 6 months ago, I didn't own a 3D printer. Now I can't imagine not having one. That psychological shift from I don't need this to how did I live without this happened faster than I expected. The Bambu Lab P1S, or as I've started calling it, Printimus Prime, has been the perfect introduction to this world. Reliable enough that I can trust it, capable enough that I'm not limited, and simple enough that my daughter can use it. But here's the irony of 3D printing that nobody tells you. The most useful things I printed in the first few weeks, they weren't life-changing household solutions, they weren't gifts for my daughter, they were upgrades for the printer itself. I thought I'd be solving problems around the house right away. Instead, I spent my first week printing things that made the P1S better. Better cable management, better filament handling, better lighting. Things Bambu Lab honestly should have included in the box. And the wild part, every single one of these mods was designed by someone else who had the exact same frustrations, uploaded it for free, and now thousands of people have printed the exact same solutions. That's the ecosystem you're buying into. Not just a printer, but a community of people solving problems and sharing the answers. So in the next video, I'm going to show you the complete first week mod kit, what to print, why it matters, and how these upgrades transform my P1S from good to actually great. Because if you just bought one or you're about to pull the trigger, this is where you start. I'll see you there.